Hello friends, welcome to my channel Civil Structures. In today's video, we will learn the design of doubly reinforced beam as per IS 456 2000. This video is sponsored by PDF Expert, a beautiful PDF editor for Mac system. PDF Expert allows you to edit PDFs, annotate, insert images, fill in the forms, sign the documents, and many more things. In this video, we will make use of this wonderful tool and get to know its features and how one can effectively make use of this tool on their Mac system. Okay, so let's get started. Here, I have already prepared a PDF for the design of doubly reinforced beam with one solved example. You can read the given example here. Each and every required data is given. Let's directly start with the calculation steps. We are considering here step number one is the basic given data. The first value is given, the grade of concrete. We can denote it with FCK. The value is 25 Newton per mm square. Grade of steel we are considering 415 Newton per mm square. The size of beam is given in width into overall depth, that is small b into capital D, and the value is 230 by 450 mm, right? Here you can see the mentioned unit is wrong. So let me correct it in mm. It is very easy to edit in PDF Expert tool. Just click the edit given on top toolbar and see here it is changed. Our next given data is the span of the beam, that is nothing but the clear length. Okay, and the value is 5.5 meter. And the support width is given here 230 mm. Now let me show you the longitudinal diagram here. Let me just insert a diagram in this PDF. To insert a diagram, click on the image, make a box. You can select a required diagram and you can easily insert a diagram in this PDF using PDF Expert tool. Here is the longitudinal diagram of beam. It is showing that beam is resting on two supports and that having a width of 230 mm, right? So these two yellow rectangles are the supports on which the beam is resting. In this diagram, you can easily understand the difference between the clear span and effective span. Clear span value is given in example, and effective span we will calculate in our next step. Okay, now let's add the cross section of the beam with the same way. I'm just inserting a diagram of cross section here, right? Here size of cross section is given, small width and overall depth is given. We will calculate effective depth in our next step, and definitely we will assume the effective cover in our next step. Step number two is to calculation of design factor load. We are taking first effective cover. We can denote effective cover with the C, right? So here I'm taking the effective cover is 50 mm. So this is the assumed data. So let me mention it here. It is a assumed. You can add the text here in PDF. So just click the text here and you can see the text box. You can just add it. Now I want to change the color of this text. I like this color. Okay. Now next step is the calculation of effective depth. The formula for the calculation of effective depth is overall depth minus effective cover. So if we put each and every value here, so the final answer for the effective depth is 400 mm. Okay, now let's move to the next step for the calculation of effective span, right? In this diagram, we have understand the difference between clear length and effective length. Okay, so now let's do the calculation for the effective span. Okay, now to calculation of effective span, we have to follow two basic conditions as per the IS code. So let's read that particular code, but before that, let me add the number. What is the clause number? So we have the clause number 22.2 in IS 456 2000, right? Now let's open the PDF for the IS 456. Let's just search for effective span.
Fine, and here we are. Clause number 22.2 on page number 34. Fine, let's read the clause. Effective span for the simply supported beam. The effective span of a member that is not built integrally with its support shall be taken as clear span plus the effective depth of beam or center to center of the support, whichever is less. Okay, so these are the two conditions we need to follow, and we need to take the lesser value from both of this condition. Now let's go to the PDF for the design of doubly reinforced beam. Okay, so here I'm taking two conditions. Clear span plus effective depth is this condition. Clear span is 5.5 meter. So if we convert this 5.5 meter in mm, that will be 5500 mm plus effective depth D. So we have already calculated effective depth C, 400 mm, and that will be 5.9 meter. That is nothing but 5900 mm. And the second condition is center to center of the support. Okay, so what is the center to center support? Let's just see in the diagram. See, we have already discussed that this is our clear length, and these two are the walls on which our beam is resting, right? So this particular thickness is 230 mm, correct? So this 230 mm, and for this we need to take the effective span. Actually, effective length and effective span both are same, so don't confuse in this. So that is why we need to take half of the width from the left support and half of the width from the right support, and just calculate the complete length, that is the effective length of the beam, right? So you just take clear span plus half of the width from the left support and half of the width from the right support. So after the calculation, the effective span of this rule as per this condition is 5.73 meter, and that is nothing but 5730 mm, right? As per the clause 22.2, we need to take the lesser value. Okay, so which one is the lesser value from both of this? 5730, correct, right? So the final effective span value is 5730 mm, and yeah, effective span we can denote with L effective. So this clause is very important. Let's highlight this. To highlight this particular text, you go to annotate. You can find here highlight text, right? I like to highlight this clause so next time when I open the IS code, it will be easy to find this particular clause, right? Okay, if you don't like the color, you can definitely change it, huh? I like this one. Okay, now let's move to the next step.
Calculation for the design moments and design shear. Okay, now see here the formula for the design moments. We already know that for simply supported beam, the formula for the bending moment is WL square by 8. So which W we are taking here? The factored UDL. Correct? We have already calculated WU. WU is equal to 53.38 multiplied by L effective square. So what is the value of L effective? L effective is 5.73 meter. 5.73 square divided by 8. So the answer is here 219.08 kilonewton into meter. Fine. Now let's calculate the design shear. What is the formula for design shear? WU capital L divided by 2. WU is the factor load multiplied by, what is capital L here? That is clear span. And what is the value of clear span given in the example? That is 5.5 meter divided by 2. And the final value for the design shear, that is VU, is equal to 146.76 kilonewton. Okay, now always remember, when you are calculating design moment, you need to consider L effective, and when you are calculating design shear, you need to consider clear span, that is a capital L, right? Step number 4 is for the calculation of limiting moment and decide the type of beam. For the calculation of MU limit, you can see here we have two different formulas. So let's figure it out which we are using for this example. You can see here the formula for MU limit is depending upon the size of beam and grade of concrete. But there is another parameter on which it is depending on, and that is grade of steel. So the first formula, that is MU limit is equal to 0.138 FCKBD square, is for Fe415. And the second formula for MU limit, that is 0.133 FCKBD square, is for Fe500. So which formula we are going to use here? We have considered our grade of steel is Fe415. So let's use MU limit is equal to 0.138 FCKBD square. So in this formula, let's put the values 0.138, FCK is 25, B is 230 and D is 400, right? Each and every values we are considering here in Newton and mm. Why we are taking that? Because the unit for the value of FCK is Newton per mm square, right? So each and every values we are taking in terms of mm, and the force we are taking for the Newton, right? And the value for MU limit is 126.96 kilonewton into meter. Okay, now for the deciding of for the type of beam, we can have two different types there: singly reinforced beam and doubly reinforced beam, right? So when your MU, that is the applied moment, is less than MU limit, then you should design for the singly reinforced beam. And where MU, that is the applied moment, more than MU limit, you need to go for doubly reinforced beam, right? And in this case, our MU value, which is more than MU limit, so we need to go for design for the doubly reinforced beam. Okay, so in step number 4, we have already decided with which type of beam we are designing, and that is a doubly reinforced beam, right? Okay, so in this step, that is step number 5, we are going to calculate for the area of compression steel, right? So the area of compression reinforcement, which we denote as ASC, and that is area of steel in compression. You can see here the formula. Before that, we need to calculate some other values which we are going to use in this formula. Okay, and that first value is XU max. We already know that when we are calculating doubly reinforced beam, we need to consider the neutral axis value as maximum. So XU max value we need to take 0.48D. So from where we need to find this formula? Definitely from IS 456-2000. We can find from page number 70. Let me just write here. Okay, now let's open IS 456-2000, page number 70. I am directly searching for the page number 70. And see, here we are. You can find here the values for XU upon D with respect to Fy. So in this example, what is the value for Fy? That is 415. So that is why we are taking here XU upon D is equal to 0.48. And here we can take XU max is equal to 0.48D. Let's put the values here, 0.48, and D is the effective depth, that is 400. So value of XU max is equal to 192 mm.
Okay, our next step is for the calculation of FSC. Why we need to calculate the value of FSC? Because you can see here, FSC value is required in the formula for the calculation of ASC. Okay, so how will we calculate FSC? First of all, let me tell you, FSC value you can find from SP16. Okay, so for this, first of all, we need to open SP16 and let's see which other values are required to calculate FSC. Okay, so here is SP16. We need to find the calculation table for FSC. For that, let me search with the word doubly reinforced beam. So whichever topic you need to find in this PDF, you just write it down in search, and it is very simple to find your that particular word in this PDF expert. So this is a table for calculation of FSC value. It is written here for table number F, stress in compression reinforcement, FSC Newton by mm square in doubly reinforced beam. You can see this table number F is on page number 13 for SP 16, correct? Okay, now let's see which other values are required. FSC is depending upon FY value and D dash by D value. Okay, so what is the FY value for this example? 415, right? And D dash by D. So we need to calculate the ratio for the D dash and D, correct? So let's understand what is D dash. D dash is nothing but the effective cover on the compression side. So this is nothing but the assumed data. We can mention here. Let me show you where will be this effective cover in our diagram. Okay, so you can see here is our cross section of the beam diagram. This is our effective cover at the tension zone. This particular portion is effective cover at the compression zone. Okay, so whatever you have provided effective cover at the compression side, that we can denote with a D dash. Okay, so that is the value 50 mm. Now D dash by D ratio is 0.125. Okay, so we have both of the values, FY 415 and D dash by D is 0.125. Now let's calculate value of FSC. Okay, so we have the values for 0.05, 0.10, 0.15 and 0.20, and our D dash by D value is 0.125. So you cannot take directly FSC because 0.125 value is not given directly. So that is why we need to do the interpolation. Okay, so which values we are taking here? We are taking for 415 values between 0.10 values to 0.15 values for T dash by D. Okay, so first let me write which values we are taking. For D dash by D, 0.1 having value of FSC is 353, and for the values for D dash by D, 0.15, FSC value is 342. And for what value we need to calculate? Value for 0.12, right? So after interpolation, I can calculate the value for FSC is 347.5 mm. Now let's see the formula for ASC. ASC is equal to mu minus mu limit upon FSC into D minus D dash. Okay, so from where we have determined this particular formula? Definitely from IS 456. Let's open IS 456. Okay, we need to go to Annexure G. So this formula we can find in Annexure G, clause number 38.1. Let me tell you, Annexure G is on page number 96. Okay, so this formula, how you can use mu minus mu limit if is equal to FSC into ASC into D minus D dash. Okay, fine. So let's put each and every value. FSC value now we have determined, so let's edit the value here. Okay, so now we have put each and every required value. Okay, and here the value for ASC is 757.43 mm². Okay, now so what will be the next step? Our next step will be to calculation for how many numbers of bar we were providing. So for that calculation we need to choose a bar diameter. That is why I am choosing here 16 mm bar diameter. So what will be the area of one bar diameter? That is 201.06 mm². Okay, and now let's calculate the number of bars. Put the formulas: total number of bars, total AST upon area of one bar diameter, right? So that is why I can calculate number of bars, 3.76. definitely we cannot provide 3.76 bars, so we have to do the round off value for the provision of the bar. So I'm taking here total four number of bars we are providing for the 16 mm bar diameter, and finally we need to calculate provided ASC 6, and we can have our total area of compression steel. Okay, it is 804.24, and finally we can write here provide four number of 16 mm bar diameter as a compression steel in the top portion of the beam. And our next step is the calculation of area of tension steel. The formula for the area of tension steel is AST1 plus AST2. Okay, from where we can find these two formulas, AST1 and AST2? Definitely from IS 456 2000. Okay, from annexure G, and here we are at annexure G on page number 96. See, that is a formula for the total area of tension reinforcement. Total AST is equal to AST1 plus AST2. We have already discussed how to derive this AST1 formula in our last video. You can find the link in description box. Fine. So see here, what is the formula for AST1 is equal to mu limit upon 0.87 fy into d minus 0.42 into xu max. Now put the values in this formula and you can have the answer 1101.08 mm square, that is AST1, correct? Now we have to determine the area of reinforcement, means how many reinforcement we are providing for the remaining moments. What is the remaining moment? That will be mu, that is the applied moment minus mu limit. Okay, and the formula for AST2 is already given here at annexure G. See, this AST2 is equal to ASC into FSC upon 0.87 FY. okay, so I think here ASC is unknown, so put the value of ASC from this formula here in this. Okay, and you can find this AST2. You can find this in clause number annexure G 1.2 on page number 96, right? Let me write here, it will be more easy to remember next time. For the same clause here, now finally we are doing the summation for AST1 and AST2 to determine the total tensile reinforcement, and the final answer is here 1830.08 mm square, correct? After this we need to calculate how many reinforcement bars we are providing, correct? So we need to choose a bar diameter, correct? So I'm choosing the bar diameter which is having 25 mm bar diameter, area of one bar diameter, that is 490.87 mm square. Now calculate the number of bars and we can determine number of bars. You can see here we have the value 3.72. So definitely we cannot provide in terms of 3.72, right? That is why we need to round off this value. Okay, so finally we are providing 4 number of bars of the 25 mm bar diameter, correct? I have mentioned here provide 4 number of 25 mm bar diameters as tension steel. We need to calculate how much reinforcement finally we are providing in tension zone. Okay, so just multiply number of bars with the smallest, that is 1963.49 mm square. Okay, so here we are done with our reinforcement providing in compression zone also and tension zone also.
And step number 7 is design of shear reinforcement in beam. Here I have done complete design of shear reinforcement with spacing in doubly beam. Have a look here. If you want to learn design of shear reinforcement, you can find this video link given in description box. So as per our calculation, we'll provide here 2-legged 8 mm bar diameter at 160 mm center to center. Okay, so we are done with our complete design of doubly reinforced beam. Now we need to draw a cross-section diagram to show how we provide reinforcement bars. See, I have not drawn a diagram in this PDF. So what I'm doing, I'm taking a new PDF with pressing Command plus N. Okay, so here we have new PDF is open. Now let's draw a cross-section diagram in this new PDF only. Just press Annotate. And you can see here, I can draw different shapes. So for the cross section of the beam, I'm taking first a rectangle. Now we'll draw reinforcement bars. So at the tension zone, we are providing 4 number of 25 mm bars. And at the compression zone, we are providing 4 number of 16 mm bars, right? So 16 mm is lesser size than the 25 mm. So we are considering here the smaller circle, right? And other editings I am doing, that taking now draw shear reinforcement with another rectangle. And lastly, we are mentioning each and every reinforcement here. See? Okay, finally, we are done with our drawing.
Now let's merge this original design file with the drawing PDF. Okay, so what I'm doing, file, merge files, select the original file first, then drawing file, and just make it merge. Fine. See, now our drawing file is also merged with the original one.
Okay, so here we are done with our design of doubly reinforced beam as per IS 456-2000. I have explained here the design steps using PDF Expert. You must go and check this wonderful software out. To download the PDF Expert for your Mac system, click the link given in description box. And yes, they also provide a special education offer at 50% off for the academic people. So thank you so much for now. We'll meet in our next video.